Now, the problem within this Vatican Jesuit expose movement has been fundamentally the spread of this tale of Islam by Alberto Rivera, Father Alberto Rivera, that has otherwise said and stated a lot of important matters concerning the Vatican affairs. So I'm not throwing away all the amount of stuff that Alberto Rivera has put forward as a low-level Jesuit, but still somebody who had a good experience within the order. And basically the fact is that Alberto Rivera, as Thomas Michel now, are people who have gone in some way against the order, one maybe in a way, one in another. Alberto Rivera, by getting too close to the Bible-believing Christians and becoming their hero, and Thomas Michel doing the same, but in the Islamic context. So what is this tale of Islam, and where it comes from, this tale of Islam, which appears in one of the publications of Alberto Rivera's comic strip? I think this is important to say, and basically it's a report about saying that Islam was created by the Vatican. And there is a lot of historical anomalies inside this report. First of all, the fact that he talks about Hadija as being the one that is Christian, the Christian wife of Muhammad, that is not correct, is Maria, and that is common knowledge for all Muslims, so there is already a big mistake. But who has created this? Well, we know that Alberto Rivera stated, in fact, that this information comes from Cardinal Bea. Well, Cardinal Bea has been on the payroll of Rabbi Abraham Heschel of the American Jewish Committee. And we have to make it very clear that Zionist influence in this matter has to always be calculated, because they work together and they each one have their own issues. And obviously the fact that Bible-believing Christians could come in the future together with Muslims and oppose in any way the Vatican Zionist conspiracy is a very dangerous matter. So Cardinal Bea spread this tale created originally by Rabbi Abraham Heschel about the Vatican having created Islam, the ancient Roman Church having been behind the creation of Islam, and this tale obviously throws disrepute upon the rest of the material which is important from Alberto Rivera. And at the same time, if somebody wants to check out why Cardinal Bea is a Zionist agent, well, you just have to go and check his the center dedicated to him, the Judaic Studies at the illustrious Papal Gregorian University in Rome is dedicated to Cardinal Bea. We're talking about somebody who was clearly close to the Zionist cause. And this Zionist cause sometimes has been used so they can separate and make haddock. And so in this way, basically, millions of people out there from Islam that will have embraced Alberto Rivera's story instead rejected.
Leo, if I could just, we're going to take a short break. I'm going to let you finish your opening statement, and then I'm going to open up for you and Eric to discuss and ask questions of one another. So I will let you finish your statement. We'll be back in 3 minutes on the Investigative Journal.
The thing is this. If we manage to clear this matter up, and this little bit of this information that is going around, which is really harming the whole movement and making it really spread much more, because I have a lot of Muslims that come to me and say, we have problems with this bit of information because truly is not correct. And so that will be of great benefit, I think, that we could unify our forces against a common enemy. The enemy is there, but the enemy will never be defeated if we are as united as in this moment where everybody is attacking everybody with the ridiculous accusation. The end of time scenario is a common scenario if you are Jew, or if you are Christian, or if you are Muslim. But the alliances that can go on in this end of time scenario are very different. And so with the Council Vatican II, we see that Cardinal Bea definitely goes towards favoring the Jewish element. And for
absolutely. Absolutely.
And for that reason, he has this particular position. And he also spread this tale that can lead Islam to be believed as a creation of the Vatican, which is, under historical conditions, completely ridiculous. I mean, there is an amount of material that I have put together that can really throw away this theory. It's just incredible that people can believe in it. So instead of most of the Muslim countries that unfortunately have fell into the hands of crooks, and most of the times this was not possible, the real freedom of saying what you want. But there is also an Islam that is not Islam of the majority, especially the Islam close to Sufism, that embraces a particular and peculiar path, which I at least think is correct for my point of view. And as I said, I made a long research regarding also the tale of Islam by Albert Rivera, and I saw that there is obviously a lot of inconsistencies historically because it's false, and I can bring forward a lot of material that proves that certain things that have been said tonight are a little bit misleading, like for example the fact that the relation with Mohammed, peace be upon him, with for example the Christians, also the non-Catholic Christians, and it was a great relation with some official writings between various people, like for example the Emperor Heraclius that ruled a vast territory of the Middle East at that time, and he received a letter from Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and he basically was astonished about the following of this prophet, which was basically the poor, the needy, and not so much the rich and the powerful. It was a religion that was really coming from the population, from the normal side of the population. And so we see that he replies in a very nice way, and this totally denounces that there was a mutual respect among people of a certain level when it comes down to God. You see, we should go back to really to the belief in one God, and then realize that is a common God for all of us, Christian, Muslim, Jews. If we realize that, we also realize that we are in a difficult time at the moment in which everybody is fighting everyone, and that a lot of false tales are said about one or the other side to damage everybody and to make really this world as it is nowadays the land of Satan, of the Antichrist, of the possibility for black magicians like the Jesuits to take over the scene very easily, because they are able to do it thanks to the fact that we are also divided on the other side. People that really are truly believing in one God should be united against the wrongdoing that a religion that calls itself Catholic and Roman is doing to Rome and doing to the rest of the world. And on that, I think we definitely agree with Eric. We differ on very many other things, but I don't think that is a problem. The main thing is that our listeners at least acquire information from both sides and are able to evaluate it after with their own research.
الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن.